Good afternoon, everybody. How is everybody today? Einstein's just finishing up his lunch. And we're going to be in the kitchen today. Hopefully it'll work out. Oh, good. A few people have joined us. Yay. Hi, cat lover. Hi, Laura. Paxton, KR Hub 79. Hi, Tia. Good. I'm glad y'all could join us. I hope your New Year's going well. We're just trying to get back into the routine of things. It seems like that's what you do the first couple of weeks of the New Year. We've been so busy, and now it's just kind of get back to the old routine. Hi, Hain. Gotta go to work. Hane's gotta go to work, Einstein. Happy New Year to all you guys. All you Birdie Brigade people. We love our Birdie Brigade, don't we, Einstein? I'm not on a tripod right now. I have it next to me, but I'm holding the phone with a little holder that I bought recently, so I'm hoping this will make some of the live streams easier. And I'm kicking Einstein's dishwater part, so he's a little upset about that. I just kicked that. See the dishwasher part? It's his favorite kitchen toy. Came off of the old dishwasher. That's okay, Einstein. Do you want it? Do you want to play with it? Here, you can play with it. Oh, normally he goes nuts over it. Go on, play with that. He's got all kinds of other toys on the floor. Oh, before I forget, one of you Birdie Brigade folks asked for an apron with Einstein's picture on it with the fork holding a piece of broccoli. And the caption reads, want some? It's good. So I've made that. And I have it on Zazzle, and I'll post a link to it in the description of this video. But I forgot now who wanted it. But anyway, I made it, and you can order it. And I'm working on other designs too, as time will allow. Okay, he's on the floor, and he's going after his what's left of it, his cell phone that a friend gave him last year. Look, Einstein. Hello, are you gonna wave? Yeah, you wanna wave? Hello. Okay, now he's going to tear up the new dishwasher. Okay, Einstein, we're going to have to get you back up on the drawer, okay? You're going to wave? Barbara, yes. Barbara asked, do you have, sweatshirts. They're coming. I don't right now, but Amazon is about to release some sweatshirts, and as soon as they allow me to sell them, I'll do that. You might want to check Spreadshirt. That's another spreadshirt.com. That's another place where I post Einstein's shirts. They do have sweatshirts, but I don't have all my designs listed on on that site. Einstein, can you say hello? Turn around. That's not your best side, Einstein. Come on. Oh, geez. Let me get some treats. You want some cheese? I have some cheese sitting out to give him as a bribe because I kind of figured he'd be cantankerous. And this is all I give him. I don't give him a lot of cheese, but boy, he sure likes it. Einstein, come here. Einstein. Einstein, turn around. Turn around. Look. Want some cheese? Want some cheese? Want some cheese? Okay. Up. Up. Oh, no, you got to get up first. Up. Up. Good boy. Good boy. Okay, get down. There's your cheese. Thanks again for joining us. Let me tell y'all something that happened to me over the holidays. I was running low on chop for Einstein, and I was getting real worried. About every 3 months, I mix up a big batch of chop. And in case some of you don't know what chop is, it's a chopped up vegetables, basically. And, he's going to go in the... Nope, don't go that way, Einstein. Anyway, I was running low, and we had a really busy schedule, and I just didn't know when I would have time to make any. So I found this website. A friend told me about it. It's called TexasNaturalFreezeDried.com. And I posted a little video of Einstein eating some of it on Facebook this last week. And he absolutely loves it. And it is such a time saver for me. It's, I'm getting some things out. They make all kinds of other things too, like this is cinnamon apples, and they make sweet potato fries. See if I can find those. Prissy Puffs. Yeah, here's the sweet potato fries. Prissy Puffs. These Prissy Puffs are so good. And folks, I eat all of this too. It is really good. I mean, it's human grade food. And all it is, it's all natural, and it's just freeze-dried. And then this is their chop. And I'm trying to get in a good light here. But it comes in brown sacks like the other, but I store mine in a mason jar. It just makes it easier to get to. And they do ship internationally, and it has been a lifesaver for me. Now when I run short of time, I just reconstitute this. You just put it in a little bit of water, and then I mix it with his sprouts, maybe some cooked grains. And anyway, really do like the product. Einstein loves it. He loves the Prissy Puffs. Einstein, you want Prissy? He's over here at the refrigerator. So, oh boy, let me see. If you're one of those that just sometimes don't have time to make chop, I'm gonna have to set this down so I can open up this package. This is definitely the way to go. Okay, Einstein, look. Look. Here. Want some? Look. Want Prissy Puff? Come here. Come here. Up. Come here. Here. Einstein, look. Here's a Prissy Puff. Want it? Come on. You know you like it. You know you like it. Good boy. Yeah. I'll even let you eat it on the floor. When he gets done with that, it's nothing but powder left. Oh, well, let me tell you what's in the Prissy Puffs while he's going back at the refrigerator. Sweet potato, pecans, banana, oats, apple juice, and unsweetened coconut. Yeah, Barbara, I don't think you can go wrong. It keeps forever. It's freeze-dried, not dehydrated, which is really more nutritionally sound. When you dehydrate something, all of the sugars in that food concentrate, and that's really not optimal. With freeze-dried, it's a different process, and just the moisture is extracted. Okay, got it. How often do you clip his nails? About once every 6 weeks, and they need clipping right now. Oh, Connie, you wouldn't believe. She says she's craving a Prissy Puff right now. I eat these things. I mean, and they're good. They're good for you. So I don't mind giving Einstein a treat. Just right now, he's more interested in showing off than anything. I was trying to read a comment there. I'm sorry. He's more interested in the refrigerator right now than the Prissy Puff. Come on. Here, want a Prissy Puff? You silly bird. Oh, good. You just placed an order. Fantastic. I'm not getting anything for telling you guys about this, but I'm not. I'm not being paid for doing this. It's just whenever I find something that I like that I think I can share as a time saver or something good for the birds, I'm all about that. So. Again, it's called TexasNaturalFreezeDried.com. So, okay, Einstein, come on over here. Come here. Come here. Up. You can come see me. Good boy. Oh, you missed. Come on. Oh, good boy. How about let's get a close-up? Yeah, there you go. You want to do some talking? Does Einstein's feet feel warm or cold? Right now they're cold because he's been on the floor, but when he's on his perch and he's got one little foot resting, all closed up, oh, that foot gets so warm. Give a kiss. Oh, yeah, he gave me a kiss. He lunged right for the camera. Okay, Einstein, listen, if you stay up there, I've got all this food on the counter, so give me a minute just to put it away, because if I don't put it away, he will dump it all on the floor. Okay. No, he's not talkative right now because I've been in here doing all the talking, but that's about to change. He's getting down on the floor. Einstein, you want some cheese? You want some cheese? Come here. Up. Okay, what's he gonna go after? What do you want? Come here. No, I don't use, someone asked, do you use coconut oil on his toes or Vaseline? Coconut oil would probably be what I'd use, but I don't do it. I don't think it's really necessary. And Vaseline, I would never use on him. Vaseline, if you look at the name, Vaseline Petroleum Jelly, it's a petroleum product. I don't even use Vaseline on myself. It's a petroleum byproduct. So, no, don't use Vaseline on your birds. Okay, I'm trying to get the cheese. See, these are my little bribes for him. Einstein, look, want some cheese? I'm going to try to get him up on the counter. Here, look. Here. Here, want some cheese? Up. Up. Gotta get up. I might need two hands for this. Jeff couldn't join me today. Oh, there you go. Good boy. Get down. Get down. Get down. He's eating the cheese. Get down. Get down. Here. Here's a piece of cheese. Here, look. Look at the cheese there. Okay. He'll do just about anything for cheese. Okay, now that he's up here, I'm going to put the camera back on the tripod and leave the room, and hopefully he'll start talking. Einstein, you do some talking, okay? I think that's crooked, but so be it. Okay, sweetie. Can you wave? Yeah. Okay. We'll see you later. Bye-bye. See you later. Be a good boy. What's a turkey? Merry corn. Go, go, go.
God bless you.
God bless you. Where are you going? Come here. No. Up. Up. Here. Up. Here. Up. Here's some cheese. Up. Want some cheese? Whoops. I'm gonna get you. Come here. Up. Einstein. Up. 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 Yep, he's being a stinker. Come here. Up. Good boy. Okay, here we go. There you go. He got down to get the tripod. That's the trouble I've been having with him lately, is that he wants the tripod. Okay, see you later, Einstein. Do some talking. Do some talking. I love you. Chicken. I'm going to reinforce him while he's up there. What's up? Einstein, no, get back up here. Here, up, up. Well, that didn't work, did it? Come here. Come here, up. 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 Come here. Up. This isn't working. Okay, Einstein, see what he's doing? Getting the tripod. No. Whee! Oh, good Lord. Come here. Up. Up. Stop it. Okay, I'm going to put the tripod. What are you doing? I'm going to put the tripod in there. Come here.
Hop aboard.
Woo-hoo! Hop aboard, love train. Come here. Do y'all know the story about how he learned that? I was cleaning one day, and his perch was right by my kitchen counter, and I was done cleaning, and I told him, hop aboard, and so he hopped up on the perch, and I rolled it across the kitchen to where it is supposed to go, and the next day he said, hop aboard. It's one of those words that he learned right away. So that's the story behind that. OK. Okay, look, here's some cheese. Want some cheese? I just gave him that. I'm just gonna sit on the floor and see what he does. He's not gonna do anything. Come here, sweetie. Come here. And come see me. No. He's fixated on the refrigerator today. Let's play. Oh, let me show y'all this. He found one of my, see, he likes it. He found one of my hot pads, and it has some of that silicone rubbery stuff on it that he likes, and he absolutely destroyed it. So it's his toy now. See, he loves it. I'm going to get it. I'm going to get it. Oh, Fairy Tale asks, is the cowbell still intact? Yes, it is. Would y'all like to see some cowbell? Dana Novak asks, do you have any advice if I want to get a bird like Einstein? Well, if just make sure you have lots of time for training and to be with your bird. They are seriously like a two-year-old for the rest of your life. I highly encourage that you adopt rather than purchase a young bird or a new bird, because the population of birds in need of forever homes is growing. They live to be 50 to 60 years old. African Greys do. And it is a lifetime commitment. So many find themselves in rescue or sanctuary situations, and there's just an abundance of really good pet quality birds that need homes. I volunteer for the Wings of Love Bird Haven, which is south of me here in Texas, and I design t-shirts that benefit them and other parrot rescues. So I highly encourage adoption, adopting a rescue over purchasing. And also, again, just have plenty of time to do it. They require a lot of patience. And it's a lifestyle change too. For example, I can't have anything, I can't use aerosols in my house. They have very, very different respiratory systems that we do. And you cannot use Teflon. Teflon heated to a temperature will kill them because it emits a toxic fume. And I can't burn candles. Because again, most candles are made with petroleum products and the wicks have lead in them, so I just don't burn candles. You can't use room fresheners for breeze that you spray on your carpets and your upholstery. You can't use that. There's just so many things you have to be so careful. Okay, oh, cowbell. Let me go get the cowbell. Einstein, you want your cowbell? Come here. Okay. I cannot take this with me, so... Well, I can't leave it on the floor is what I mean. I'll be right back with the cowbell. Here's your cowbell. I don't let him play with this except for Sundays. Cowbell!
He's so excited. Yes, he is.
My noisy refrigerator just started up, so excuse that noise. Einstein. Get it. Get it. Wave. Yeah. What's a cow? Oh, he's going to go to the prissy puff. Nope. He just had lunch, so he's probably not very hungry. Thank you guys for all the nice comments. I really appreciate that. I can't read all of them because I have to keep an eye on him and where the camera is. Einstein, here's your cowbell. Get it. Go get the cowbell. I think he is thinking all the time, Sylvia. I think he's thinking constantly. What can I get into now? What's in here? I know treats come out of that little room there. Can you wave? Come on. What's a turkey? What's a turkey? Can you talk to me? Talk to me. Peek-a-boo. Peek-a-boo. Okay, come here. Up. Oh, so sweet. So sweet. Okay. Whoa. I just fell on my butt. I can't get up off the floor. Oh, shoot. Okay. You notice I said the word shoot. I'm very careful. You have to be when you have a parrot. That's another lifestyle change. You can no longer curse. Come here. Whoops. Here you go. Can you get down? I'm okay. I just fell backwards. I need to do more of my squats. Oh, he's gonna eat a little bit. Let me go get the prissy puff for him. Hang on. Here. Here. Want this? I'm sorry, guys. Up. Come here. Up. Good boy. Down. You know, this is live, so there's no editing. What happens, happens. If I fall on my back end, well, I fall on my back end. Another thing you have to realize when you get a parrot is they are messy and they can be loud. Their job is to tear up things. That's what they love to do. And although Einstein isn't talking very much now because I'm in the room with him, he can get loud and he can squeal when he wants something and he's not getting it, when he's not getting his way. He can be loud. Okay, Einstein, if I put this in the tripod, will you be good? Will you be good and do some talking? Let's see. Let's see. Okay, you be a good boy. I'll be right back, okay? What's a turkey? What's a turkey?
Peek-a-boo. Monkey. What's a squirrel? What's a dog?
Woof, woof. Police, police.
Peek-a-boo.
Einstein, Mary Corn. Waving, yes. Good boy. What's a rooster? What's a rooster? What's a rooster?
Cock-a-doodle-doo.
See, what's going on now? I do have the camera. Oh, come see me? Okay, I do have the camera on a tripod, but I'm out of sight. And for some reason, he prefers to speak to me when I'm out of sight. I think it has something to do with contact calls with other birds that they would do in the wild. I don't know, but Einstein, what's a rooster? Now he's decided to quit talking. And he's probably going to come over here to the tripod. I'm backing myself into a corner. I need to go this way. Come here this way. How about get your cowbell? Here, look. Look. Get it. Oh, yeah, get it, baby. Dana Novak asked, do birds like him cost a lot? I don't know what the going rate for an African Grey is now, and I'm sure it depends on where you live, but again, check with a parrot rescue near your location, and they can tell you more about that. Yeah, somebody just said she believes it's around $850. We paid $800 20 years ago. And the cage is about $1,000, and toys are about another. Oh, to get one suited up with toys and perches, that's probably about another $300. They have to go to a specialized vet, an avian vet, and so those vet visits are more expensive. And I should probably be closing my dining room doors. Looky there, Einstein. Let's shut these doors, okay? Stephanie Johns asked, does he like to cuddle? Yes, he does. He likes to cuddle with Jeff. And I have a video on YouTube about that, of him cuddling with Jeff. Just do a search on YouTube, Einstein Parrot Cuddle. And I think you'll come up with some videos. He won't cuddle with me like he does Jeff. Cuddling to him is just sitting on my knee. So, Casey says, every time Einstein stops talking, Peaches leaves. Well, sorry. Yes, he can fly. Einstein, do you want to fly? You do. How long does it take them to learn to talk? Well, okay, some never do learn to talk. I have a couple of friends who have grays, and all they do is make sounds. But for Einstein, it depends. Sometimes he learns words right away. Other times, it might take him a week. Sometimes it might take him months. And then sometimes he never learns the word. Like when he counts to 10, he will not say two. He will not say thank you. I've tried to teach him thank you and he will not. So I think it kind of depends on if the bird is interested in the word or not, and if it's if he wants to learn it. Can your bird say build the wall? We're not going to get political. Sorry. Yep, that's a story for another time. Does the freeze-dried food contain cheese in it? No. All the ingredients for natural TexasNaturalFreezeDried.com, all the information is on the website. They list all the ingredients, and no, there's no cheese in it. Well, I'm glad y'all are enjoying Einstein just being Einstein, but it's funny, he's acting this way in part because I think I have the tripod here and he's just trying to get my attention. Let me try to go over the other side of the island and see if I can get him at a better angle, because that angle there, that's better. And naturally he's gonna move. Einstein, you're just being a stinker today, aren't you? Thank you guys for hitting the like button. If you haven't hit the like button, give us a thumbs up. We appreciate that. And if you haven't subscribed to Einstein, please consider that too. I try to do at least one video a week in addition to these live streams. And these live streams have just become a staple now in my routine. The only time I think I would not be able to do one is if we went out of town, so, or if I got sick. Whoops, sorry, I hit the tripod there. Oh, thank you for the like.
All right.
All right. Okay, I'm just gonna step away and just let him do what he does. See you later, Einstein.
Turn around.
Okay, I'll turn around. You're a good boy. Be a good boy. I'll see you later. Oh, I left, and there he goes with the tripod again. Goodness gracious. We're going to have to figure out something to where you don't attack the tripod. If you have any suggestions, Birdie Brigade, please let me know. I took it off, so I'm just gonna follow him around with the camera. Hang on. Cowbell. Plastic stick. That was a toy that had a rattle on the end of it, and the rattle broke off, and he just loves that little... Oh, do you want to come see me? It looked like he wanted... Come on, want to come see me? Anyway, it's just, now it's just this plastic tube. Well, I'm trying to show, that he just absolutely loves. I think he likes the way it sounds on the floor and on the counter. Whoop. Oh, you're gonna wave? Try to zoom in and out here, there. You gonna wave again? Oh, you're being shy. You being shy. Someone just recommended a Joby Gorilla Pod. Well, I got one. And it has silicone, those little silicone rubbery things, because it bends and you can attach it to things. He likes that tripod because it has that silicone on it. So what I'm thinking I'm going to do, I'm going to try to make some kind of sock for it to cover up the legs on that tripod, because I bought it and now I can't use it because he goes nuts whenever he sees it. He attacks that one too. I have an egg crate, in case y'all are wondering. I have an egg crate, an egg carton in there to keep him from going in the back of the refrigerator. We bought this new refrigerator, and it's a little narrower than my old one, and he is insistent upon getting back there. So that's a piece of what we call PCM, and that's abbreviated for parrot countermeasures. Keeps him from doing what he's not supposed to do. Because you're a stinker. Come here. Come see me. Cowbell. Cowbell. Want cowbell? Okay. Oh, do that. Somebody just wrote and says both her birds now say come see me. That's sweet. Yeah, our house is full of PCM. This PCM keeps him from being in the cabinets. That piece of PCM keeps him from going in that cabinet. He's learned how to open up the doors, the cabinet doors, and the drawers. So yes, we have changed our life to suit him. Oh, baby locks, no, they don't work. He goes right through them. He will eat the plastic to the point where it bends or is no longer useful as a baby lock. And the magnetic ones, we've tried the magnetic ones that you have to use another little magnet to open the cabinet. Well, then he'll start chewing the wood. We tried that in our bathroom, and he started chewing the cabinet door because he wanted in there. If he wants something bad enough, he will do whatever it takes to get in there. So that didn't work either. For about the first 10 or 12 years of his life, he wasn't that curious. He wasn't that exploratory. But it only happened within the last 8 or 9 years, I guess, that he has just become Mr. Explorer. So, okay. Well, I tell you what, the time has just flown by. Pardon the pun. Hasn't it, Einstein? The time has just flown by. And we appreciate all you guys for joining us in our little corner of the world here in Texas. And we're going to sign off, get on with our day. And y'all have a great week. And we'll see y'all next week on Sunday at 2 o'clock, okay? All right. Thank you guys for joining us. Einstein, can you wave? Yeah, he can say that. Can you wave? Wave. Okay. Y'all have a good week. Love you guys. Bye-bye.